Yeah.
Okay. Hey everybody, I'm Tyler from Max Ordinate. I'm here with Jim Millet from Millet Engineering. Okay, I also have George from US Optics. Okay, today we're going to be testing a few different rifle scopes. All right. On Jim's machine, he designed and engineered it. Okay, it does a variety of different tests. We have a fire test, which is testing recoil, focus test, power test, box test, and parallax test. So Jim, why don't you tell us about light transmission and what the companies actually tell you and how you're testing on a real scale basis.
Okay, you'll see a lot of companies advertise we transmit 98% light, little number, big numbers like that. That's a standard test for lens coatings. A single laser beam is sent down the center of a single lens to get that number. Light transmission is only one parameter. There's up to 60 parameters that you can test with this equipment.
Gotcha.
And we'll go through that step by step with various testing.
Okay, the scope that we have in here is a US Optics LR17. Okay, it's got a 30 millimeter tube with a 44 millimeter objective lens.
You'll see here, the scope that's in here right now is transmitting 66%. What I measure is the brightness of the entire target. The white X that you see is actually a target in the collimator. And you see the reticule in front of it generated by the scope. The camera is being used as a light meter. And we are adjusting the light source in here always back to the same exposure. This number is generated by how much energy it takes to get back to that same exposure. What we're measuring is the brightness of the whole image. That's what's important to a shooter.
Tell me about the fire test.
Right now our machine is set to 50 pounds pressure. That's equivalent to 30-06 area. I quite often get the question, what gun are we simulating?
I see.
You can't say a gun. Depends on the weight of the gun.
Mm-hmm.
Depends on the rigidity of the scope mounts.
Of course, yeah.
It depends on the weight of the scope. This is all a system. So you can't say this gun.
Yeah, each rifle has a different felt recoil. I understand.
Right. The maximum that I can generate here is half inch BMG.
Okay.
That's about 3,500 Gs. So we're going to fire.
Now our next test would be the focus test.
We change 0.3 MOA in going from focus at infinity to focus at 50 yards.
I see.
That's actually quite good. Let's continue to power test.
All right, power test.
Position was saved. Now set to a lower power. I'll just run you down to the bottom here.
All right, down to 3.2.
Now this says a lot about this scope. Remember when we changed focus, we just moved one lens.
Correct.
To change power, we're going to move two lenses.
I see.
Within a tube that's inside the scope.
Right.
Okay. Has to be a very thin wall tube, and you've got little scrolls milled around it so that the lens is all moving the right place.
Move forward, back.
The lenses have to fit that tube very precisely. 1/1000, if this is an average design, 1/1000 of an inch clearance on what's holding those lenses would be one MOA.
I see.
You've got to control the exact focal length of 10 lenses.
Aha.
Okay?
Got it.
You generally have a 3% tolerance on focal length.
So our next test is the box test.
This is the first time he's ever operated this machine. It's in automatic mode. He's the dummy.
I am the dummy. Once the illumination is done adjusting, I will move the reticle 4 clicks in each direction. We'll see if it comes back to zero.
Okay, the last test we have to show is parallax. This asks you to slide the camera up until you don't get a scan. We're going to come up. See what you see? See that? What you see there?
Scope shadow.
That is at the edge of the exit pupil.
Yes.
Okay? So we're going to just get a scan on that side. And we're going to say okay. Now we're going to slide the camera down.
So that we get the...
There you go.
Blur on the top, okay.
Okay. Now, this is simulating just moving your eye up and down.
Yeah.
Every once it's asking us to return the camera to center.
Aim point was 0.0 MOA. That's a pretty good parallax.
No parallax in the scope.
That's good.
Millet Sights was started by my brother and my mom and dad. It's a family business. And when I came into the business, we had this slogan that one-third of our product takes three trips across the Pacific because we had a lifetime warranty and our manufacturers had to take back what wasn't good. Okay, and a third of what we would get wasn't good. But who was our quality control? Didn't have these machines. Our customer was our quality control. If they sent it back, we'd had an inspection guy that would check it out. Yeah, he could find something wrong, or maybe he couldn't, but we'd give him a new one. We built three of these machines. We 100% computer tested every scope. Our reject, now we still had 30% going back and forth, but the customer didn't get it. Our reject rate from the customers dropped to 3%. And most of that was because of bad scope mounting. They would send us back a scope, say, this thing isn't holding aim point. If we put it on the machine, oh yes it does, check your mounts. Don't hear anymore. That's what these machines do.
That's fantastic.
Perfect. Well, it sounds like what we're going to do now is we're going to program the system for this particular model, and then we'll get a printout that we can show the world.
Yeah. But you're set up right.
Perfect. George, what do you think about the test so far?
That's very impressive that you can capture so many different performance details for an optic, and it reflects what we set our standards for in our shop.
There's...
Are you ready for this?
Yeah.
All right. Hey, everybody.
We
I'm Tyler.
Oh,
cut.
Hey,
everybody. I'm Tyler from Max Ordinate. I'm here with Jim from Millet Engineering. My bad. Sorry. We could start over. Are we filming right now?
Yeah.